Last Sunday was the last episode of Frame by Frame, where I tried to find movie mistakes. And we also made a movie mistake. The first person who would find that one wins a Jenny Catch t-shirt, and that winner is Triple Petal. So congratulations. Now, for today's video, I have 5 advanced tips when creating text or 2D animations inside Adobe Premiere Pro. So let's get started with the first one. What I've got right here is a simple rectangle and a text on top of there. Now, with the rectangle selected in the Essential Graphics, we can pin that to the text. Next, choose which edges of the background shape needs to be pinned. In this case, we'll select all of them. Now, whenever I choose to change the text now, the rectangle background will automatically adapt its size to the length of the text because it is pinned to it. And this is definitely useful when you choose to save your design as a template for later use. Now, for instance, a lower third that you can use more often in your work. Now, talking about templates, while you're editing a video and you have a specific text that appears multiple times, you could save their styles as a preset. For instance, this heading title and subtitle. Select the desired layer and locate the master styles in the Essential Graphics. Choose Create Master Text Style and give it a name. Hit OK, and we'll do the same for the subtitle and also save that into a master style. Later in the edit, we want to create a new heading. We can then just simply type our text, go to the Essential Graphics, and in the drop-down from the master styles, choose our saved heading preset. All of the styles will now be applied to this title. And again, the same goes for the subtitle. You can save as many master styles as you want. Tip number 3, we can drag stills or even videos into the Essential Graphics. On top, I'm gonna create a new text. Then with that text layer selected, on the bottom, we can find Mask with Text. And this will reveal the video through that text. Another great use of the mask feature is when you have a text with a simple position animation on it. What we would like to do now is reveal it. So instead of animating a crop effect, I'm going to apply a rectangle over the text on its end position. With that rectangle selected on the bottom, enable mask with shape. And this will now only reveal the text within that shape, creating a very nice reveal animation. Now I've got 2 more really awesome tricks coming up, but first a big thanks to our sponsor Storyvlogs Video. It's an incredible library packed with stock clips, video effects, overlays, and so much more. Now it keeps expanding, so there's always something new to find. And what I also love are their After Effects templates, going from complex logo animations to simple 2D animations. You can simply download them, change the text, and render it out without even having to know how After Effects works. We have been using Storyvlogs for years now, and even if they wouldn't sponsor us, I would still recommend it to any creative. With a fixed single price per year, you can download unlimited video assets, which makes it so incredible. So definitely check it out, which you can do by clicking the first link in the description down below. And now, let's continue with tip number 4. I've got a background rectangle in my Essential Graphics, but I would like to add some kind of a gradient fill to it. It's not possible through the styling options, so what we can do is actually locate the ramp effect in the effects library and drag that to the Essential Graphics. And this does allow me to create that beautiful gradient color that I'd like to create. And this brings me to the last tip. I'm gonna use the transform effect in my Essential Graphics because that allows me to create an animation while also enabling motion blur by setting the shutter angle to 180. Now, since the transform effect needs to be on top, it will be applied to everything in my graphics panel. A workaround for that is to create groups. Select the transform effect and the layer that you want that effect to be applied on and click on create group. And this places the 2 into a bin, and so the transform effect will only be applied to the layers within that bin. And this allows you to create some very nice animations like you can see here using various effects. And that was already it for today. I have just finished my brand new class for Adobe Premiere Pro for advanced users yesterday. So I've been working throughout the entire weekends lately, so I'm very tired. So that's why I'm gonna take this Thursday off to charge my batteries again so that I can go back to making longer videos. And I actually have some very cool concepts planned for July. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyvlogs, for the support. Don't forget to check them out. And as always, stay creative. So guys, tomorrow is gonna be D-Day for my hair. I told the hairdresser to take the entire day for me, because this is probably gonna be a lot of work. He's not gonna touch my beard. No, the beard will stay. It's my girlfriend. She just really doesn't want me to have this hair. Also the beard. But the beard is staying.